What is up, everyone? How are we doing? Hope everyone's doing well. So this month I've been on YouTube for 1 year, and over that time I've gotten asked the question, what kind of cameras do you use? What's your MotoVlog setup? So I thought I would go ahead and make a video just kind of briefly talking about my MotoVlog setup and what I use. First things first, helmet. Okay, so the helmet is a Bell Qualifier, a very affordable helmet. I think you can pick them up for like 130, 120 bucks. Out of all my helmets, this one has been the quietest. For a mount, I use just a cheap knockoff GoPro mount. It's made for more of the POV view. See, I mounted the bracket there. And when I stick that, I stuck that with obviously the pads that they give you. And then I epoxied that in. You don't want that GoPro going anywhere. Straps in there. And your GoPro would mount there. That's the angles I'm shooting with. So the cameras that I use are GoPros. My main camera that I use, that most of my vlogs are shot with from my helmet, are the GoPro 7 Black. It's what I'm shooting this with now. The secondary camera I use is a GoPro 5 Black. You know, to be honest, I bought this one refurbished. I've had less issues with this one than I have the 7, which the 7 I bought straight from GoPro. Right out of the box, problems. Glitching where it would just freeze, pull the battery, pop it back in. I've yet to really have that problem with this GoPro 5. Suck it, GoPro. But overall, I've been happy enough with the cameras, so. So I do use an arrangement of filters. ND filters, polarizers, I think different times call for it. Usually there is some type of filter on my cameras, whether it be, like I said, the neutral density or the polarizers. The microphones I use, the oh so popular purple panda mics. I keep it just tucked right in the cheek there. Extremely happy with the purple panda mics. I think for like 50, 60 bucks, You can pick them up on Amazon. I've tried a few of them. Purple pandas seem to do the best for the littlest amount of money. So the other piece of gear you would need is your mic adapter. This is a must. You cannot catch audio off of your mic unless you have one of these. 50 bucks. An irritating purchase, in my opinion, because it's just a little adapter. 50 bucks, come on. But you gotta have it. It's just the way it is. The way that works, guys, is I've got Velcro in the back of this. Velcro right here on the helmet. We just Velcro there. Just plug right into your camera here, like so. Run your mic up into your helmet and you just bring it out there and plug right in. Your mic, hopefully you can see it. There'll be three rings on this prong that your mics come with. The GoPro adapters do not take that adapter. So most of the mics that you purchase, that I have purchased at least, will come with a two prong. It's hard to tell, I mean, I don't know what to call it, but your mic jack will have only two rings that the GoPro will accept. Most of the mics will give you this small, short connector. If you can see the difference in these, one has three black rings, one has two black rings. The two is what you want. You'll plug in the little one and then into your adapter. I've gotten down the road, shot video, you wind up back home with no audio. So those are just some of the things I use for the MotoVlogging setup.
Just great.
So those are just a list of some of the things I do. Plenty of these videos out here, plenty of MotoVlog setup. I thought it would put my name in the hat, trigger some of those algorithms. If you guys don't follow the channel already, check me out. Obviously, I do MotoVlogs.
Yeah.
Appreciate you guys if you got to this point. Thank you for watching. All my subscribers, thank you guys a lot. You guys are awesome, and I'll see you guys on the next one.
Here we go.
Are you serious?
Okay, that's it.
Not you with a MotoVlog setup!
GoPro can suck it.
Okay, that's enough.